Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi everyone, how are you today? Okay, today we will focus on grammar focus, which is topic is some and any. Okay, if you get your Get Smart Plus 4, you can turn to page 51, okay, Walim Shukri as your teacher, okay. Okay, first, some, which is they have two section, which is countable and uncountable. Okay, for example, I give on my slide, there are some food on fridge. Okay, there are some food on fridge. Okay, so what is countable? Countable ni adalah benda yang boleh dikira. Uncountable adalah benda yang tidak boleh dikira. So, food, some food. Fruit on fridge. Maksudnya, buah-buahan di dalam peti ais. Jadi, some fruit. Fruit tu boleh dikira. So, this is some we use untuk boleh dikira. Some. Sebahagian. Mungkin ada sikit, mungkin ada banyak. Kita tak tahu. Maksudnya boleh dikira. Okay. Number two. I have some money on my bag. I have some money on my bag. Okay. Money is uncountable. Okay, kenapa kita cakap the uncountable? Sebab jumlah wang yang dalam yang berada dalam bag duit dia tu, okay, kita tak tahu berapa. Okay, some money mungkin RM1, mungkin RM2, mungkin RM3, mungkin lebih pada tu. Okay, put some the next example is put some sugar on the coffee. So, this is uncountable. Okay, kenapa Mualim cakap sebagai uncountable? Sebabnya sesetengah orang dia suka gula tu nak letak dalam kopi dia manis, jadi dia akan letak banyak. Jadi gula ni tak boleh dikira. Okay, so next slide. Okay, another example is to offering or requesting. Apa maksud offering? Offer ni maksudnya kita tawar dia. Okay. Ataupun request. Request ni maksudnya kita minta pada dia. Okay. For example, would you like some more tea? Adakah kamu nak lagi teh? Jadi, ni adalah salah satu daripada soalan lah. Eh? Jadi, this is countable. Jadi kita boleh kira. Mungkin nak 2 kali tambah ke, 3 kali tambah ke. Eh? Okay. Another example, could I have some water please? Boleh tak saya dapatkan sedikit air? Okay. This is requesting. Requesting. Okay. Apa maksud requesting? Request ni maksudnya meminta. Jadi dia minta air. Ni pun boleh. Air uncountable. Kita tak tahu berapa jumlah yang dia nak. Kalau teh tadi, kita boleh kira mungkin 2 cawan, 3 cawan. Okay. Next. Okay. For any. Any, we can use in negative sentence and question sentences. Okay. For example, number 1, she doesn't have any money. So, she doesn't have any money. Jadi, dia tiada duit langsung. Jadi, any ni, any money, maksudnya money tadi, kita kira sebagai uncountable. Kita tak boleh kira jumlah duit. Mungkin dia tak ada duit langsung, mungkin dia ada duit tapi mungkin dalam bank. Okay. Does she have any sister? Okay, the second example is, does she have any sisters? Okay. Dia tanya, adakah dia ada kakak ada tak kakak. So kakak ni kita boleh kira mungkin adik-beradik dia ada 3 orang, dia ada 2 kakak, so, 1 abang, mungkin. Okay, so is countable, boleh dikira. For positive sentences, doesn't matter which one. Okay, for example, number 1, which color should I color anyone? Okay, which color should I color anyone? So, maksudnya di sini, warna apa yang patut saya warnakan? Anyone. So, dia jawab anyone. Mana-mana pun boleh. Jadi, nak guna warna, nak warna apa, tak kisah. Okay, number 2. You can call me anytime. You can call me anytime. Apa maksud dia kat sini? Awak boleh telefon saya bila-bila masa. This is how we use any in sentences. Okay, macam mana kita nak gunakan perkataan any dalam satu ayat. Baik. For today's, thank you. See you again. Bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.